Put the helmet on, buddy.
Ear tube surgeries are the most common procedures that are performed in children. The tubes are typically put into the ear because kids are having problems with accumulation of mucus or they're having recurrent ear infections.
Can we go ahead and look in your ears now? You've got some pretty handsome looking ears, young man.
And so we did a study looking at the records of kids who received tympanostomy tubes or ear tubes.
We used a large data set of patients who are insured by Medicaid. This was roughly 100,000 patients that we were following to see whether there were detrimental effects. The findings of our study show that patients who are exposed to quinolone eardrops have an about 60% increased risk for permanent eardrum perforations, which would require surgical repair, compared to patients who received another class of antibiotics, specifically neomycin eardrops, which is an older antibiotic, which is still used commonly as an eardrop as well. Quinolone eardrops are actually the most commonly used eardrops for ear infections.
I think that the study does show that some antibiotic eardrops within the quinolone class may be worse than others. For example, we also found that the additional use of steroids, which is included in some eardrop preparations to reduce the inflammation more quickly than the antibiotic alone, these may actually make it worse.
Open big.
I think that we as physicians need to be a little more circumspect as we prescribe antibiotics to keep in mind that there is no completely benign medication, that there's always some potential consequence when we give a medication to a patient. And we just need to keep in mind that we don't want to use them any longer or any more often than we absolutely have to.